श्लोक शंकरम शंकरम शंकराचार्यम केशवम बादरायणम सूत्र भाष्यकृत वंदे भगवन्तं पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने धूमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ब्रह्माणमिदधाति पूर्वं वेदागुच्च प्रणोति तस्मै तरुणः देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्येऽं शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रीचिद्घनगणेशानमोऽयं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिर्मलमपारं वेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परमहः तदेवाहन्नमत्तोऽन्यदिति मे निश्चितामतिः So we are looking at what is Shakti and what is Lakshana. In Siddhanta, we have seen Shakti is the sambandha between Pada and Padartha. That is called as Vritti also. And in English, we will say it as a direct meaning of a word and then extending to the sentence also. Lakshana is an indirect meaning when we go through Parampara sambandha. So you go from one to the other and then continue till you land on the final meaning. Okay, just give me a moment, some are still trying to join in. This is the section where we look at the other interpretations of Shakti, or what exactly is that reveals the meaning, direct meaning of a word. So yes, in the Naiyayika Mata, Shakti Vishe Matantara Khandaram, Ishwar Ichha Eva Pada Shakti Riti Naiyayika Uktam Na Sadhu. It has already been refuted that Ishwara Ichha is not the Shakti which reveals the word. Otherwise, it will always be so. We will always understand whatever has been uttered. We have seen the refutation in the last part. Ishwara Ichha Tavad Ishwara Nishtaha Dharmaha. Now, if you go through the technical analysis of where is the Dharma, the Shakti, Ishwara Ichha. If Pada Shakti is Ishwara Ichha, then Ishwara Ichha should be in the Pada Shakti, in the Pada itself, which is not the case. Where will Ishwara Ichha be resting? Ishwara Ichha as a Dharma will be in Ishwara. If you are talking to a Naiyayika, this will be the analysis. Ishwara Ichha Tavad Ishwara Nishtaha Dharmaha. Ichha as a Dharma should be in whoever has that Ichha. So if Ishwara has that Ichha, then there is a Shakti Sambandha there. Therefore, in Ishwara, there will be, he will be the Adhishthana for Dharma called Ichha. Natu Pada Dharma. In Pada, there won't be Ishwara Ichha. Pada will not be the Adhikarana for Ishwara Ichha to be there. Just because it is Ishwara Ichha, it is not Pada Ichha. सो न तो पद धर्म ईश्वर इच्छायाः पदनिष्ठत्वा संभवात् पदशक्ति इति वक्तुं न शक्यते. सो इफ यू एनालाइज इट जस्ट बाय तर्क आल्सो शुष्क तर्क यू कैन नॉट से दैट ईश्वर इच्छा इज पद धर्म अदरवाइज इट हैज टू रेस्ट इन पद एंड इफ यू से दैट ईश्वर इच्छा इज पदनिष्ठ देन एनीथिंग कैन बी एनीवेयर. यू कैन नॉट टॉक अबाउट एनीथिंग बीइंग एनीवेयर. Nayayika's analysis falls apart in each and every case if he still asserts that Ishwara Ichha is in Pada. Thereby you cannot call it as Pada Shakti also. Ishwara Ichha cannot be Pada Shakti. Shakte Pada Dharmatve hi Pada Shakti Riti Vaktum Yujyate. If Shakti had been Pada Dharma, then it can be called as Padashakti. Therefore, Ishwarichha cannot be called as Padashakti. What is Padashakti? Is that which is there in the Pada itself. Ataha Padanishtha Arthavabodhana Samarchamyo Padashakti Syat. So what is Padashakti? It is definitely Padanishtha Dharma, and that is Samarcham, which is the capacity to reveal the meaning. Avabodhana Samarcham. So Nayayika Mata is refuted. Siddhanta we have already established as Sambandha. Samarthya to reveal the meaning itself is Padashakti. Vayakarani Ritya Shakti Lakshanam Tavat Padanishthartha Yogyata. It is quite close, but still there is a difference between a Vayakarana, grammarian, talking about Padashakti. What is this Padashakti? He says Shakti Lakshana, the definition of Shakti is Padanishta Artha Yogyata. So Artha Yogyata, Indriyanam Savisheshu Anadir Yogyata Yatha Anadir Artha Shabdanam Sambandho Yogyata Tatha. So they say there is something called as Anadi Yogyata. Just like Indriyas have Yogyata to go towards their own Vishayas, similarly Padas have some Yogyata of Anadi, this is Anadi Yogyata, Arthai Shabdanam Sambandha. But they call it as Yogyata, and Yogyata says fitness to reveal the meaning. It is not the capacity to reveal the meaning, there is a subtle difference there. Thereby, we have to refute the Vayakarana Matha also. Iti Vayakarana Bhushana Sare, in some Karika, 36 Karika there, some work of Vyakarana Varka, it is mentioned. Indriyanam Savisheshu Chakshushadishu Ghatadishu Yatha Anadihi Yogyata Tadiya Chakshushadi Karanata Tatha Shabdanam Api Artheza Tadbodhakata Eva Yogyata. Saiva Shakti Rityata Iti Tad Vivaranam. So there is a description given in such a manner. Manjushayantu Vachyavachaka Bhavakarani Bhuta Padartha Yoho Tadatmyam Shakti Riti Iti Yuktam. Iti Yuktam. So Iti Yuktam means what has been said in elsewhere. Vachyavachaka Bhavakarani Bhuta Padartha Yoho Tadatmya Shakti. So Tadatmya is Shakti. So in some way it is an identification. You identify when you say ghata, you know this as a ghata object. The shabda and object are somehow connected. Now that yogyata or tadatmya shakti is what the vayakranas consider. In the initial case we have seen that the way there is anadi yogyata in the indriyas to go towards their own vishaya, so vishaya. But it is not agreeable, because yogyata and samarthyam have different connotations. So that is Shakti Lakshana in Vyakarana. Padanishtha Artha Yogyata Nama Padanishtha Padartha Bodha Hetutvam Eva. Now what is this Yogyata? If you ask the Vyakarana, he has to say that it is that which is the cause for revealing the meaning. And that Dharma is sitting in the world. So Padanishtha Artha Yogyata Nama Padanishta Padartha Bodha Hetutvam Eva. That being the case, Ghatapade Kalasha Rupartha Jnana Hetutva Rupa Yogyata Asti. In the Pada Ghata, Ghatapade Kalasha Rupa Artha Jnana Hetutva Rupa Yogyata Asti. When you hear the word Ghata, then in Ghata there is the Ghatapada, there is Yogyata. What is that Yogyata? It is Yogyata which is a cause to bring the knowledge of the Kalasha Rupa Artha, the object which is in the Kalasha Ityadi. Sa Yogyata Eva Shaktihi. Now what is this Yogyata? We have also been saying that it is that capacity to reveal the meaning. It is not the fitness to reveal the meaning, if I have to literally translate it. But it is the capacity to reveal the meaning, and If you inquire further, there cannot be any difference between the Shakti that Vedantin talks about and a Vyakarana talking about as Yogyata. It is Shakti itself. He need not say that it is not Shakti, but it is Yogyata. Thereby, Sa Yogyata Eva Shakti. Ayamartha Harikarikam Pramani Kritya Vyakarana Bhushanakya Granthe Nirupitaha. So they describe it, but they do not agree that it is the Samarthya Sambandha. Vyakarana Abhimata Shakti Khandanam. Now this is being refuted by the Siddhantin. Arthajnana Hetutva Rupa Yogyata Shaktiriti Vadan Prashtavyaha. So the one who is expressing this, the Vyakarana, he should be asked, Kim Bhavanmate Pade Samarthyamasti Utanasti Iti. Now, he should be asked, the Vyakarana, is there Samarthya in the Pada to reveal the meaning or not? Let him say Yogyata, but we ask him, is there Samarthya or is there no Samarthya in the Pada by itself? Ghata Pada, revealing the Ghata Artha, Kalasha Rupa, is there Samarthya in the Pada or is it not there? Adye, if he says that Samarthya Masti, then Aspad Abhimata Shakti Rangi Krita Bhavati, then there is no difference between what we are saying and what you are saying. You can call it as Yogyata. If Yogyata is just a Paribhashika Sabda without any Yogika Artha, then we don't have any dispute at all. So, what we call as Shakti, which is Sambandha Rupa, Samarthya Rupa Shakti in the Pada, you call it as Yogyata, it is okay, but as long as you accept that there is Samarthya, then there is no meaning in differentiating and hair splitting. Dvitiye Loka Prasiddha Samarthya Rupa Shakti Reva Pada Shakti Rityabhyupeya. Sorry. In the second case, where he says, Pade Samarthyam Eva Nasti, in that case, what is this Shakti? Loka Prasiddha Samarthya Rupa Shakti Reva Pada Shakti Rityabhyupeya. Then you have to accept that what people accept, I mean, generally what is known as Shakti, that is Samarthya Rupa. If you say this in the Pada, there is no Samarthya, then whatever is, Shakti is there, that is Samarthya. Natu Padanishta Artha Bodha Hetuta Rupa Yogyata Pada Shakti Riti. Then your definition falls apart. Why? Because you are saying there is no Samarthyam, but there is Yogyata. Because Padanishta Artha Bodha Hetuta Rupa Yogyata Pada Shakti Riti Na. What is Pada Shakti? Pada Shakti is that Shakti which is Samarthya Rupa as well known in the world. So you cannot say in Pada there is no Samarthya but there is Yogyata. There won't be Yogyata also. So there won't be Shakti at all. You cannot say there is Yogyata Rupa Shakti while Samarthya Rupa Shakti isn't there. So Yogyata won't be there. Thereby in both cases, either he has to agree with what you know what we are saying, or he cannot establish anything as to how the Pada reveals the meaning. Ayam Abhipraya, it is described further because the last sentence is a little convoluted. Pade Samarthyam Abhyupa Gachata. So one who is Samarthyam Abhyupa Gachan, one who accepts that there is Samarthya in the Pada. Vayakarana. Pade Samarthyam Abhyupa Gachataha. Tadrsha samarthyatirikta shaktyantarabhyupagamaha na yujyate. So one who accepts the shakti which is samarthya rupa, he need not talk about any yogyata rupa shakti. Kintu samarthyam eva shakti riti abhyupagama eva yujyate. So what is tenable, logically, he has to accept that both are same. He need not separate out. Why? Because shakti, Samarthyam, what are these words? Samarthyam, Balam, there is another word called Joke, Shaktihi, Iti Etesham Padanam, Ekartha Bodhakattva Prasiddhehe. Because the Prasiddha Artha, Rudhi Artha of Samarthyam, Balam, Joke, Shakti, all that is same. So whether he accepts Samarthya and denies Shakti and says, Yogyata is Shakti. Yogyata has no such connotation. He has to use either Shakti or say Samarthyam. Samarthyam being accepted and calling something else as Shakti इज मीनिंगलेस देयर. अतएव लोके सामर्थ्य रहितं पुरुषं अशक्तोयम् इति वदन्ति. व्हाट इज रियली शक्ति? शक्ति इज सामर्थ्यम. शक्ति कैन नॉट बी एनीथिंग अदर देन सामर्थ्य, बिकॉज इट इज वेरी वेल नोन दैट इफ अ पर्सन डज नॉट हैव शक्ति, हु इज कॉल्ड अशक्त पुरुष, ही इज व्हाट? सामर्थ्य रहित. He does not have any capacity to do anything in a particular area. Let's say he does not have capacity to do something, then he is called as Ashakta in that context. So Shakti has the inherent meaning of Samarthyam. They are interchangeable, there are synonyms. Therefore, when you say Shakti, it is Samarthyam. When you say Samarthyam, it is Shakti. There cannot be any word which is different from सामर्थ्य बट मीन शक्ति लाइक योग्यता. किंच भर्जितं प्ररोह असमर्थं बीजं दृष्ट्वा अस्य बीजस्य अंकुरोत्पादन शक्तिर नास्ति इति वदन्ति. सो इफ द वैयाकरण सेज ओके अशक्ता, शक्तः अशक्त हैज दैट मीनिंग बट आई डोंट एग्री विद शक्ति, देन अनदर एग्जांपल इज गिवन सो दैट लैंग्वेज इज अंडरस्टूड. Obviously, Vyakarana knows this language because he has expertise in Padashastra. However, Shakti word itself is used in this manner. Kincha bharjitam praroha asamartham bijam. The bija, the seed which is roasted, cannot germinate. So when it cannot germinate, germination is its Shakti. So बीजस्य अंकुरोत्पादन शक्तिर नास्ति इति वदन्ति. पीपल से दैट इट डज नॉट हैव कैपेसिटी टू जर्मिनेट, इट डज नॉट हैव शक्ति टू जर्मिनेट, हैविंग सीन दैट काइंड ऑफ बीज व्हिच इज रोस्टेड व्हिच इज प्ररोह असमर्थम. सो समर सामर्थ्यम इज नॉट देयर, शक्ति इज नॉट देयर इज व्हाट इज मेंशन्ड. इत्थम सामर्थ्यम शक्ति इति पदयोर एकार्थत्वं लोक प्रसिद्धम. इट इज वेल नोन. वैयाकरण ऑल्सो knows it, he has to accept it, maybe he has not thought about it, therefore we tell him that when you say samarthyam is there, then shakti is there, there is nothing else that we need to discuss on this front. Agna api samarthya rupayo shakti riti nishchitam. In agni also it has a capacity to burn, that itself is its shakti. Tasmat pade api samarthyasya eva shaktitvabhyupagamah yuktah. पदे सामर्थ्यम अंगीकृत्य तद्विलक्षण योग्यतायाः शक्तित्वाभ्युपगमे लोक प्रसिद्धि विरोध स्यात्. यू विल बी गोइंग अगेंस्ट दी जनरल यूजेज विच इज वेल नोन एंड एज अ वैयाकरण इट इज नॉट बिफिटिंग फॉर यू टू डू सो. देयरफॉर वी टेल हिम दैट एक्सेप्ट व्हाट वी आर सेइंग. इफ यू से सामर्थ्यम इज देयर इन द पद देन शक्ति इज एज वेल एज एक्सेप्टेड. सामर्थ्यम योग्यता इत्युच्यते. इति यदि वैयाकरणो ब्रूया तदा सिद्ध्यत्येव अस्मन् मतम्. इफ ही सेज योग्यता, वी कॉल योग्यता दैट सामर्थ्यम इटसेल्फ एज योग्यता, देन वी हैव नो आर्ग्यूमेंट्स एट ऑल. वी से यू कॉल इट एनीथिंग एज लॉन्ग एज दैट सामर्थ्य इज शक्ति, वी डोंट हैव एनी इश्यूज. अथ यदि वैयाकरणो ब्रूया सामर्थ्याभ्युपगमे हि पदे अपि सामर्थ्य रूपा शक्तिरेव भवेत् इत्यापद्येत न सामर्थ्यम् अंगीक्रियते अस्मन् मते. If he says, okay, samarthya is shakti, but we don't accept samarthya itself, then the second option is picked by him. Then, tasmad arthajnana janakattva rupa yogyata eva padashakti riti. Then, arthajnana janakattva rupa yogyata. He says that yogyata to generate the knowledge of the object or the meaning of the word. That is padashakti. Tadasa prashtavyaha. Then he should be asked about this yogyata that he calls as shakti. In that case, samarthyam kim pade kevalena angi kriyate uta agnyadi sarvapadartheshu api iti. So if he is trying to get by saying that in pada there is no samarthya, the way you the siddhanti talks about, but there is yogyata to generate the knowledge regarding the object, then we ask him, is it that you don't agree with samarthya being there in the pada, or do you don't accept any samarthya in any vishaya also, padartha also? For example, agni, which is our stock example that we have used in the earlier part has. So Sadhu has said, in Agni there is a Daha Samarthyam, Dahana Samarthyam. The fire has capacity to burn. The word fire, by extension, has the capacity to reveal the meaning of that object which can burn. So it reveals that real fire, the worldly fire which can burn, which has the capacity to burn. Now, as soon as the Vaiyakarana says that I don't accept that there is anything like Samarthya to reveal the meaning in the Pada. So in the example of Agni Shabda, the Agni Shabda, Agni Pada does not have Samarthya to reveal the meaning Agni of fire, the object fire. Then we ask him, is this Samarthya not accepted in the Pada or also in our example that we extended? In the Padartha also. So do you say that there is no Samarthya in Agni to burn also? You cannot say that I accept the Samarthya in the Agni to burn and then say that I don't accept the Samarthya in the Pada. So Tadasa Prashtavya Samarthyam Gim Pade Kevale in Angi Kriyate Uta Agnyadi Sarva Padartheshu Apiti. There is nothing called as Samarthya, whether in the Pada or in the Padartha. Dvitiya Pakshana Yukta. He cannot say I don't accept that there is no Samarthya in Agni. There is Samarthya in Agni to burn. If he says no, I don't accept it, that is not tenable. Agnyadi Sarva Padartheshu Samarthya Rupa Shakti Sadbhavasya Puram Yukti Bhi Sadhi Tattvat. We have already explained that earlier when refuting the Nayayika. Thereby, you cannot say that there is no Samarthya in Agni at all. And any other Padartha. Every Padartha has some Samarthyam. Pade kevalam arthabodha janakatva rupa yogyata eva shaktihi natu tadatirikta samarthya rupa shaktirasti iti prathama pakshe dvitiya pakshokto yodoshaha vanyadav samarthya rupa shaktyangi anangikare pratibandaka sanidhye dahadyanu anutpattir na upapadyeta ityadihi sadosha yadyapi nasti tathapi pade samarthya anabhyupagame tathapi pade samarthya anabhyupagame असमर्थम पदम योग्यम सामर्थ्यहीनम पदम अर्थज्ञानं जनयति इति भवदीय सिद्धांत इति पर्यवस्यति. सो वी टेल दी वैयाकरण नाउ, इफ यू एक्सेप्ट दैट देर इज नो पद सामर्थ्य, सो द रिफ्यूटेशन ऑफ द नैयायिका, इफ यू गो बैक एंड सी, see agnyadu agnyadi agnyadi atirikta dahadi karya jananukula samarthya rupa shakti sadbhava kathanam. In this topic we had seen that the uttejaka versus the pratibandha. In that analysis we have seen that there is daha karanai bhuta kevala agnye, there is some shakti there. So dosha which has been shown there, that the agni does not burn everywhere, it burns only when pratibandhaka is won over by the shakti, therefore shakti has to be inferred. That is samarthya rupa shakti. Now if the vayakarana says that agnyadi sarva padartheshu api samarthyam nangi kriyate asmabhi, we the grammarians do not accept that there is samarthya in the padartha also. So in the example of the agni, it does not have samarthya to burn if he says that. And whatever is the reasoning given, like Nayayika, the same flaws will accrue there. The Agni burns without Samarthya, so Agni should always burn. But Agni does not always burn when there is Pratibandhaka of Jala Ityadi or Mani, Mantra, Aushadi we have seen. Does not burn. So Shakti has to be inferred, whichever is stronger will win over. Now, if he says that I accept that Samarthya in Padartha but not in the Pada. So Pade Kevalam Arthabodha Janakatva Rupa Yogyata Eva Shakti. I accept Yogyata but not Samarthya if he says that in Pada. Natu Tadatirikta Samarthya Rupa Shakti Rasti Iti Prathama Pakshe Dvitiya Pakshokta Ya Doshaha. In the second case, whatever flaw was there, even if that isn't there, what was the flaw? Vanyadav samarthya rupa shakti anangikare प्रतिबंधक सानिध्ये दाहाद्य अनुत्पत्तिर न उपपद्येत. सो व्हाटएवर द दाह सामर्थ्य विच वी टॉक अबाउट ही डजंट टॉक अबाउट बट हैविंग एक्सेप्टेड इन द पदार्थ नाउ ही सेज सामर्थ्य इज इन द पदार्थ. देयरफॉर द फ्लॉज दैट वी पॉइंटेड आउट इन नैयायिका पक्ष दैट डज नॉट अक्रू टू द वैयाकरण. In the case of padartha, however, in the case of pada, what will happen? Ityadi sadosha yadyapi nasti, tathapi pade samarthya anabhyupagame. Sati saptami, if he were to not accept this samarthya in the pada, but only accepts it in the padartha, then asamartham padam yogyam, he says yogyata is there, but samarthya is not there. Then we'll put it in an anvaya for him. So what is it that you are really saying? You are saying this pada is asamartha. Do you agree? Yes, he says. Because samarthya is not there in pada. Therefore, what is that pada? That pada is asamartha pada. So asamartha pada, but it has yogyata. Therefore, what is that pada? That pada is yogya pada. Therefore, if you put these ideas together in a simple sentence that Vaiyakarana loves, he loves an anvaya. So he will see that asamartham padam yogyam. He has got asamartham padam on one side, prathama ekvachana, which has been predicated to be yogya on the other side. Meaning what? Samarthyahinam padam arthajnanam janayati. It has yogyata to reveal the meaning, but it has no samartha to reveal the meaning. So that which has no capacity to reveal the meaning is fit to reveal the meaning. What kind of fresh nonsense is this? He also can see through that flaw. Samarthya heenam padam arthajnanam janayati iti bhavadiya siddhanta iti paryavasyati. This is what we have to conclude, that this Vaiyakarana, who is philosophically quite close to siddhanti, he makes such kind of a statement. He cannot make such kind of a statement. So if he picks that paksha, then he will, you know, be making a statement which cannot stand scrutiny. Tadidam asangatam. That is very, you know, illogical. Padantu asamartham eva tathapi arthajnanam janayati iti eta iti esha tavoktihi ayam napunsakaha tathapi ayam oghavīryaha. Iti ukti vad atyantam vyahata. So we insult him further, meaning how foolish it would be to say that somebody who is a napunsaka, you know, he has capacity to father many children. That kind of a thing is being talked about here, which is ridiculous. Samarthya yuktam hi samartham, samarthya heenam cha asamartham, asamarthena na kinchidapi karyam siddhyati iti loka prasiddhi. And it is well known, we don't have to explain it, that asamartha, you know what these words mean, Vaiyakarana knows it better than us. So we don't need to discuss this further. Loka prasiddhi is there as well, that kinchid, you don't need to be a Vyakarana pandita to understand what loka prasiddhi is also there. Asamarthena na kinchid api karyam siddhyati. One who is asamartha or what is asamartha cannot, you know, accomplish any karya. Tatascha asamarthena padena arthajnana rupa karyam api na sambhaved eva. So we know this, it is concluded now. Tasmat pade samartyam avashyam abhyupeyam. Therefore the Vaiyakarana also has to accept what? Pada has samarthya. If he says yogyata is there, then samarthya is there. You cannot have yogyata without samarthya. Evancha bharjite bije ankurotpatti hetutvasya iva asamarthe pade arthabodha hetutvasya asambhavat arthabodha hetutva rupa yogyata na padashaktihi. Thereby what is concluded is that in bharjita bija there is no ankura utpatti hetutva. So if it has yogyata, it has samarthya also. Without samarthya, even ankura utpatti hetutva yogyata isn't there in bija. Similarly, pade artha bodha hetutvasya asambhavat, if Asamartha pada is there, then it cannot have artha bodha hetutva yogyata. Therefore, artha bodha hetutva rupa yogyata na pada shaktihi. Kintu ya, therefore, what has to be accepted that this yogyata definition, which has been talked about, that is not pada shakti, kintu sa yogyata padasya yena samarthyena sampadyate. Tatsamarthyamiyo padashakti rityabhyupeyam. This yogyata is not really what is called as shakti. That yogyata is made possible due to which samarthya, that samarthya is padashakti. So, kintu sa yogyata padasya yena samarthyena sampadyate. You talk about somebody being fit due to what capacity he or it has. That itself is shakti. So that subtle difference is revealed now. Initially we said if you call it yogyata we don't mind, but then if you go through granular analysis, then what he is saying as yogyata, that yogyata is possible due to samarthya. It is not same as samarthya, it is possible due to. So one becomes yogya because he is samartha. Samartha and yogyata are not, samarthya and yogyata are not interchangeable really, the way shakti and samarthya are interchangeable, but that capacity which makes possible for one to be fit, that itself is that pada to be fit to reveal a meaning, whatever he says, hetutva ityadi, artha bodha hetutva, that is possible due to which samarthya, samarthya is what samarthya is sambandha. Tatsamarthyamiva padashakti rityabhyupeyam. Thereby Siddhanta is established even in the case of argument with or debate with a vayakrana. Tatascha loka prasiddha samarthyasya eva shaktitvangikarena kopi doshaha. Therefore, it is better to accept what people generally accept regarding padartha in the case of pada also. There is no defect there. Bhattamatena Shakti Lakshanam. Puro Mimamsaka, Bhattas, what do they say? So, Bhatta is Kumarila Bhatta iti, Bhatta Pada iti, Chasya Vyapadesha. So, Bhatta, when Bhatta is talked about in Shastra, there it is Kumarila Bhatta there, or he is also called as Bhatta Pada, so we call it Bhagavat Pada, Bhatta Pada. Iti Chasya Vyapadesha, Mandana Mishrasya, Prabhakarasya cha, Ayam Guruhu. He had two Shishyas, Mandana Mishra and Prabhakara. Mandana Mishra we know as one who Bhagavat Padacharya had a debate with in Purva Mimamsa. He was, so Kumarila Bhatta was his guru. Jaiminiya Purva Mimamsayaha Vartikam Ayam Virachayamasa. So Kumarila Bhatta has made these Vartikas which are very famous in Purva Mimamsa. And these Vartikas are used by Siddhantis also. Vedantins also use these Vartikas in the case of Karma Kanda. And there is a Chitsukacharya also accepts that in Laukika we agree with, in Vyavaharika Laukika we agree with Bhattamata. So padasya arthena sa tadatmya rupaya sambandha sa shaktiriti bhattamata mata anuyayinah ahuhu. What are the followers of Kumarila Bhatta saying, Purva Mimamsakas? They say that what is a shakti? That shakti is sambandha alright, but it is tadatmya rupa sambandha. Pada padarthayo tadatmya rupa sambandha. Meaning what? There is no bheda at all, aveda. And this is what we usually build upon also. Siddhanta is also like that, but Siddhanta is a little different. It is not through the Shakti and that kind of Sambandha. We don't say it as a Tadatmya Sambandha. We explain it through Shruti Vakya, Akaro Vai Sarva Vak, and Mandukya Mantra, Omkara is all this. However, the Purva Mimamsakas, Bhatta say that tadatmya rupa sambandha asti padasya arthena sa. So pada and padartha are connected through tadatmya rupa sambandha, and this tadatmya definition is different between Purva Mimamsaka and Uttara Mimamsaka Vedantin. सोयम तादात्म्य रूप संबंध भेदाभेद स्वरूप इति च ते कथयन्ति. What is तादात्म्य? Generally we translate तादात्म्य as identification in English. However, this तादात्म्य रूप संबंध for a पूर्वमीमांसक is भेद अभेद स्वरूप. भेद also, अभेद also. What is that? टिप्पणकार से अभाव सादृश्य भिन्न प्रतियोगी सापेक्ष ज्ञान विषय चत्र संबंध इत्युच्यते. ज्ञान विषय, इट इज अ ज्ञान विषय, दैट इज संबंध एंड इट इज टेक्निकल नाउ. प्रतियोगी सापेक्ष, इट हैज एन अपेक्षा ऑफ, इट इज अलोंग विद द अपेक्षा ऑफ अ प्रतियोगी. एंड व्हाट इज दिस? अभाव सादृश्य भिन्न, इट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम बीइंग सिमिलर टू अभाव, एक्सेप्ट्स अ प्रतियोगी and is a jnana vishaya, that is the sambandha which is tadatmya here. Yatra yadvastu sambadhyate tadadhikaranam aniyogi iti uchyate, yadvastu sanyogi tat pratiyogi iti uchyate. So the counterpart is called as pratiyogi, and wherever it rests, in the case of say ghata, what is ghata? Ghata is घटा अभाव प्रतियोगी. सो काउंटर पार्ट घटा एंड घटा अभाव. वेयर इज दिस घटा नाउ? दिस घटा इज ऑन द भूतला. लेट्स से भूतले घटोस्ति, देन भूतला इज अधिकरण फॉर द घटा, एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अनियोगी. एनीवे he is just explaining that it has no bearing on what we are looking at. Sambandhasya aneka vidatve api sanyogah samavayah tadatmyam iti traya pradhana bhutah. Sambandha are is of three types. Sambandha is defined here. This is not limited to what I said earlier, that sambandha is general definition now. So abhav sadrushya bhinna pratiyogi sapeksha jnana visheshchatra sambandha ityuchyate. Sambandha is of three types. Sambandhasya aneka vidatve api, broadly, although sambandhas are of many types, broadly they are categorized into three: sanyoga sambandha, samavaya sambandha, tadatmya sambandha. Pradhana bhuta, these are primary categories, and then there are subcategories. Broadly there is sanyoga, samavaya, tadatmya. Tadatmya is what is the sambandha which is called as shakti. Pada and padartha sambandha which is tadatmya rupa sambandha, which is bheda abheda swarupa, that shakti is the pada shakti, that is called as pada shakti as per purva mimamsakas. Ayam cha tesham abhipraya, what is the idea there? Agni riti padasya vanni rupaarthena na atyantam bhedaha. Now very interesting, what is this tadatmya sambandha between the agni and so agni and agni as padartha, agni shabda and agni padartha, to differentiate between that, you know, to not misunderstand the word fire and the real fire, he has used two different words. In Sanskrita you have used agni is as pada and vanni as artha, just for to, you know, not repeat that as agni pada and agni artha. Instead of that he says agni is the pada, and what does it depict? It depicts vanni, the fire. Between this agni and vanni, is there any difference? There is no difference. Atyanta bheda is not possible. Atyanta bheda sati, had there been a difference between the word agni and the artha vanni, atyanta bheda sati yatha agni padad atyanta bhinna jaladi padarthah agni riti padena na pratiyante tatha agni riti padena आग्नि पदाद् अत्यंत भिन्नः वन्नी रूप पदार्थः अपि न प्रतीयेत. When someone says agni, does vanni come to the mind? Meaning, when someone says fire, the word fire, does the real fire come to mind? It does. Had they been extremely different from each other, अत्यंत भिन्न, then just like this jala padartha, water does not come to mind when someone utters the word fire. Atyanta bhinna, jala is atyanta bhinna from agni. So their argument is, since jala does not come to mind when I uttered the word agni, similarly if there had been atyanta bheda between agni and vanni padartha, agni shabda and vanni, I'll use this padartha and I'll use these, although it is not there in the moola, we'll see this, otherwise it is a little confusing. So agni pada and vanni padartha, had there been atyanta bheda between them, then just like there is atyanta bheda between jala and agni, similarly there would be such kind of a difference between these two, agni and vanni, and then agni shabda wouldn't bring vanni to the mind, vanni padartha. Suna pratiyante, but that is not the case, therefore they do not have atyanta bhinnatvam between them. Agni pada and vanni padartha are not atyanta bhinna. So basically what, pada and padartha are not atyanta bhinna, using this example. Tatha agni riti padena agni padad atyanta bhinna vanni rupa padartha api na pratiyeta. Had there been atyanta bheda, you wouldn't have this pratiti at all when you hear the word agni. Padasya swarthena sa atyanta bheda bhavavad atyanta abhedo api nasti. Then would you say that is atyanta abheda? Now this analysis is similar to our mithya analysis, sarasadbhyam vilakshana, that we talk about. Here they are not establishing bheda bhinna abheda bhinna, they are establishing bheda and abheda together. So quite an interesting stuff. Padasya swarthena sa atyanta bheda bhavavat atyanta abheda api nasti. There is no atyanta abheda also, just because there is atyanta bheda, which is proved to be not there. So atyanta bheda isn't there. Then atyanta abheda do you accept? No. Vanni pada and vanni padartha are not same, definitely. Otherwise, one who utters agni will burn his tongue. So it is very obvious. Yadi atyanta abheda vachya vachakayo syat, tada अग्नि पद वाच्यार्थ भूता वन्निना यथा मुखं दह्यते तथा अग्नि रूपार्थ वाचकाग्नि शब्दोच्चारण मात्रेणापि मुखं दह्येत. जस्ट लाइक फायर बर्न्स एनीथिंग, लेट्स से इफ यू टच फायर इट वुड बर्न यू, और अदर एग्जांपल इज दैट योर माउथ विल बी बर्न्ड इफ यू ईट समथिंग हॉट, सो वेयर अग्नि इज देयर, सो यू से यू नो नॉट ओनली फायर बट यू से देयर इज फायर इन फूड ऑल्सो. व्हेन यू ईट अ, nobody is going to eat fire, but then there are these magicians, whatever, you know, magic shows or whatever it is. So the tongue is burnt by fire, but tongue is not burnt by utterance of the word fire. So agni utterance does not burn your tongue, but putting real vanni in the mouth will burn your tongue. Therefore what it is, not atyanta abhinna also. So this is very obvious. Natu tatha agni shabdam uccharetuhu purushasya mukhan dahyate tasmad vachyavachakayor na asti atyanta abhedo api. So nasti atyanta abhedo api nasti. So atyanta bheda nasti, atyanta abheda nasti. Apitu agni padasya vanni rupaarthena sa bheda sahita abheda vartate. There is bheda along with abheda. Very contrary to logic, but they say this is the kind of sambandha between vachya and vachaka or pada and padartha. Bheda sattvan mukhanna dayyate abheda sattvat agni riti padena vanni pratitir jayate. So bheda sattvat, if they were different, so because bheda sattvat mukhanna dayyate, it is said in the other way now, because there is bheda, therefore the mouth isn't burnt on utterance of the word agni. And abheda sattvat, because abheda is there, agni riti padena vanni pratitir jayate. When you say agni, then the vanni rupa padartha comes to mind. Therefore, bheda is also there, abheda is also there. Yatha agni riti padasya vanni rupaarthena bheda sahita abhedo vartate tathaiva udakam vanam neeram jeevanam ityadi padanam jalarupaarthena sa bheda sahita abhedo vartate. Similarly, this is extended to other words and all words then. So jala, if you take udakam, if you take the word udakam, udakam, vanam, neeram, jeevanam, these are all synonyms for jala. Ityadi padanam jalarupaarthena sa bheda sahita abhedo vartate. So there is bheda and abheda both between the pada and padartha, whether it is agni and vanni, jala and udaka, or any other word with its synonym when you look at the padartha. So any pada and padartha, they are connected through tadatmya sambandha, which is bheda sahita abheda rupa sambandha. There was a continuation of the earlier point, I think. Yeah, so we have not seen this. So here we'll look at the tippana. It is quite a long drawn tippana to explain what is tadatmya sambandha for a Vedantin versus what is the tadatmya sambandha for a Purva Mimamsaka. So we'll go through this. This is a little we'll see how much we need to go through, but it is good to know what is tadatmya sambandha, because we use it a lot. Vedantin uses tadatmya sambandha a lot, so we need to know what tadatmya sambandha is there for an Advaitin versus contrasting it with Purva Mimamsaka. So we'll stop here, we'll continue in the next part. Sukam nityam saprakasham vyapakam nama rupe adhishthanam buddhe bodhyam buddher drukyattu nirunaparam sarva vedanta vidyam pratyak paramaha tadevahannam attonyaditi me nischitamatihi. Tat sat.